Not all happiness is created equal. What's up, brothers and sisters? This is what I want to talk about in this video. A few days ago, I was on the phone with a friend of mine. This friend has sort of walked away from the Christian faith. They had been in our church, now they're going a different direction, and they were talking with me, and we were kind of going through this short conversation, and they were updating me on their life, and the person said, "I am happier than I have ever been." The person is like, "I am really happy at this moment with the choices that I've made." And I had to say to them, I was like, happiness is often good, but I couldn't say like, "I'm glad you're happy," and like, it's okay. And here's what I want to present to you. Not all happiness is created equal, right? Like, not all happiness is even necessarily a good thing, okay? You can be happy because you're torturing cats, or you could be happy because you're planting flowers, right? Like, which happiness is actually a good thing? You see, it's not just about being happy. There's this big idea in our culture, especially in the younger generation, which this person belongs to, that says, do whatever makes you happy, right? If something delights you, if you enjoy that thing, if that is your thing, then you go ahead and do that. But not all happiness is equal. The value of a happiness, like the goodness of a form of happiness or a source of happiness, is based in the goodness of that source itself, right? Like, if I gain joy out of something that is wrong, if I gain joy out of something that is detrimental, something that's damaging, something that is impure, something that is painful for another, right? Like, that joy isn't a good thing. If I gain joy from sin, the Bible says that sin is pleasurable for a time, but in the end it leads to death, right? You can find happiness in all sorts of things. Our hearts are malformed. Our hearts delight in lots of things that they shouldn't. The other day I was at Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. I do martial arts, and I was competing with a friend of mine, and we were fighting, and I got in a bad position, and he was beating me, and then we went off the mat, and we went back to restart, and I realized that I could have put myself back in that bad position and let him start in a dominant position, but I just kind of let us start from a neutral position. And afterwards, I caught myself and I was like, man, I cared more. I was finding more happiness in winning, in beating my friend. In the end, I felt like I had won kind of our competition moment there. And in the end, I was like, man, I got more enjoyment out of beating my friend than in being fair or in allowing him to have the dominant position, in like doing what's right and what would have been kind to him. And I was like, man, that is a wrong happiness. A lot of time for myself, I find happiness in competition in which I win and I don't put my neighbor first. I should find happiness in putting others first more than I find happiness in winning. I should find happiness in prayer and reading my Bible and going to church more than I find happiness in watching a football game. But sometimes my heart isn't there. What is the source of your happiness? Don't trust something just because it makes you happy. Don't bless something and someone else just because it makes them happy. But ask for a discerning heart to know, like, is this a good happiness? Is this a happiness that comes from something that's actually good? Or is this a happiness that comes from something that's in between or something that's even negative? Psalm 16 verse 11 says this. It says, you make known to me the path of life. In your presence is fullness of joy. At your right hand are pleasures forevermore. Here's what we need to do in a world that just gives permission to anything that makes you happy. We have to have discerning hearts, and we have to pray and say, Lord, show me what is truly good. Show me where my joy should be. Most of all, put my joy in you. Place my joy, place my happiness in the right places. Not all happiness is created equal. Be careful where you're finding that joy. Be careful what you're affirming in other people because it makes them happy. Find good happiness. Find happiness in God. Ask God for a heart to take pleasure in what is right. Thank you.